Welcome to this session on design of clutches. The subject design of machine elements 2, subject code 18962 of VDU. So in the last sessions, I had discussed about the design of single plate clutches and multi plate clutches. So in this session, I'll be discussing about the design of cone clutch. Myself Sandesh Kamath, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Department, Kendra Engineering College. So next is the third type of clutch, that is cone clutch. So as we can see from the figure, so it is called cone clutch because of its shape. It's in the conical shape, the friction lining, okay. So the contact surfaces which come into contact, okay, so they are in the conical shape. So it consists of a driver or cup and a follower or cone. So the cup is keyed to the driving shaft with the help of sun key, and it has an inside conical surface or face which exactly fits the outside conical surface of the cone. So this is the cup. And here we can see this is the cone. So the slope of the cone face is made small enough to give a higher normal force for the clutch. So the cone is fitted to the driven shaft with the help of a feather key, and the follower may be, or the cone may be shifted along the driven shaft by using a forked shifting lever in order to engage the clutch by bringing these two conical surfaces into contact. Next is the derivation of the torque transmitted by the cone clutch. So let us consider the diagram. So here the cone clutch is shown, in which it is having the conical surface. So let the inside diameter be indicated by DI and inside it is by RI. Similarly, the outside diameter by DO, outside radius by RO, and let D suffix M be the mean diameter of the cone, and the width of this face, that is denoted by B, that is the face width, and also left this angle that this face makes with the horizontal, okay, so that is called as semicone angle or pitch cone angle or face angle, and the pressure intensity that is indicated by small p, so this should be small p, and the coefficient of friction is denoted by mu, and the axial force is denoted by Fa. So let us consider this. So this should be R0 and RI respectively. Here also this should be R0. This is the outside diameter. This is R0. This is RI. So for the purpose of analysis, let us consider an elemental ring at a radius R as shown in the figure. Here is the elemental ring shown. So this particular elemental ring is need to be considered for the purpose of analysis at a radius small r. So whose thickness, like in the radial direction, is given by dr. The normal force that is acting on the conical surface is given by the equation number 30.10 from the design data handbook. It is given by Fa divided by sin alpha. Considering the elemental ring of at a radius r and having radial thickness dr, area of this elemental ring is given by 2 pi r into this sloping length. Just let the sloping length be denoted by dl. So therefore the sloping length dl is given by, if we take this sine of this angle, okay, so then we will get sine alpha as dr by this sloping length. So therefore the sloping length is given by dr by sine alpha. So that is this one. Next, coming to the substituting this in the area of the ring, so that will give 2 pi r into dr by sine of alpha. Next, normal force that is acting on the ring is let it be denoted by delta f suffix n. So that is given by pressure intensity into this area of the ring, that is 2 pi r into dr by sine of alpha. So that is, let that be equation number 1. So we have seen the normal force that is acting on the ring. So axial component of that force acting on the ring is given by delta f suffix a, that is equal to delta fn into sin alpha. So therefore delta f a is given by substituting the value of delta fn, you get p into 2 pi r into dr by sin alpha into sin alpha. So here the sin alpha and sin alpha gets cancelled. So therefore delta F A is equal to 2 into pi into p into r into dr. So let us take this as equation number 2. Now the total axial force is given by integrating this expression whatever we have got for the elemental ring. So that is integration of 2 pi p r dr from the limits ri to r naught or da by 2 to d naught. So in this case I will use the limits as ri to r naught. So let's take this as equation number 3. So now the frictional force acting on the ring is given by coefficient of friction into the normal force that is acting on the ring. So that is mu into delta fn. So now delta fn value we have that is nothing but p into 2 pi r into dr by sin alpha. So therefore the frictional torque that is acting on the ring is given by frictional force on the ring into the radius r. So therefore the total torque that is transmitted by friction is given by t is equal to integration of 2 pi mu p r square into dr by sin alpha from the limits ri to r naught. So let's take it as equation number 4. Let us first consider the first criteria, that is the uniform pressure theory. So the total axial force is given by Fa is equal to integration of 2 pi pr dr from the limits ri to r naught. So here since the according to the uniform pressure theory the pressure is assumed to be constant over the entire the friction phase, so therefore we can take p outside, so it will be 2 pi p into integration of r dr. So if you integrate this you get r square by 2 from the limits ri to r naught. So applying the limits we get so here 2 and 2 cancels. So it will be pi into p into r naught square minus ri square. So therefore the value of the pressure intensity is given by expression Fa over pi into r naught square minus ri square. From equation number 4 we have torque T is equal to integration of 2 pi mu p r square dr by sin alpha from the limits ri to r naught. Since p is a constant according to uniform pressure theory, so taking p outside along with the term 2 pi mu by sin alpha we get integration of r square dr. So integration of r square is r cube by 3. So applying the limits we get torque T is equal to 2 pi mu p by sin alpha into R naught cube minus R I cube divided by 3. So therefore, substituting for the pressure, expression for pressure, 2 pi mu by sin alpha into expression for pressure is Fa divided by pi into R naught square minus R I square into R naught cube minus R I cube by 3. So here pi gets cancels. This can be written as 2 mu Fa divided by 3 sin alpha into R naught cube minus R I cube divided by R naught square minus R I square. So we have the expression for the torque. So converting the radius to diameter, so what we get is T is equal to mu Fa divided by 2 sin alpha into 2 by 3 d naught cube minus d a cube by d naught square minus d a square. So when we convert this radius to diameter, we will get this extra term 1 by 2. So rearranging this, we get T is equal to mu Fa into dm divided by 2 sin alpha, where dm is given by 2 by 3 d naught cube minus d a cube by d naught square minus d a square. That is nothing but the mean diameter. Next, according to the second criteria, that is uniform wear theory, as we have discussed in the case of single plate clutch, here also it is assumed that the wear will be uniform or it will remain constant. So therefore the product P into R remains constant. So from equation number 3, we have axial force is equal to 2 pi integration of 2 pi PR dr from the limits R I to R naught. So from this, taking this constant product P into R as a constant and representing it by C, we get Fa is equal to 2 pi C integration of dr. So integration of dr is R, and applying the limits, what we get is 2 pi C into R naught minus R I. So therefore the expression for C, we will get it as Fa divided by 2 pi into R naught minus R I. So from equation number 4, we have T is equal to integration of 2 pi mu p r squared dr by sin alpha from the limits R I to R naught. So taking this product, that is P into R as a constant C, and taking it outside, we get 2 pi mu into C divided by sin alpha into integration of R I to R naught R into dr. So integration of R is R square by 2. So applying the limits, we get, so here 2 gets cancelled. So pi mu c over sin alpha into R naught square minus R I square. So substituting for this expression for C, we get T is equal to pi mu by sin alpha into Fa divided by 2 pi R naught minus R I into R naught square minus R I square. So simplifying this R naught square minus R I square term as R naught minus R I into R naught plus R I. So therefore here this term gets cancelled. So therefore T can written as mu into Fa divided by 2 sin alpha into R naught plus R I. So converting this R naught plus R I into that diameter, what we get is mu Fa divided by 2 sin alpha into D naught plus D I by 2. So this can be rearranged as torque T is equal to mu Fa dm divided by 2 sin alpha, where dm is nothing but the mean diameter given by the expression D naught plus D I divided by 2. Next, coming to a problem on cone clutch. A cone clutch is to transmit 7.5 kW at 600 rpm. The face width is 50 mm. The mean diameter is 300 mm and the face angle is 15 degree. Assuming the coefficient of friction as 0.2, determine the axial force necessary to hold the clutch parts together and the normal pressure on the cone surface. So
in this problem, they're given the power RPM, the face width, that is small b, is given as 50 mm, mean diameter is 300 mm, the face angle is nothing but alpha, that is 15 degrees, and coefficient of friction is given as 0.2. So given this data, we are required to find out the axial force FA and the normal pressure on the cone surface, that is P. So using the equation for the power, since the power is given, we can find out the torque. So substituting the values of power, that is 7.5 kilowatt, and RPM 600, so the value of torque that we get is 119366.20 newton millimeters. Next, in order to find out the axial force, we can make use of the equation for torque for the cone clutches given by the equation number 13.10d in the design data handbook, that is capital T is equal to mu FA dN over 2 sin alpha. Substituting the values of the torque, coefficient of friction, mean diameter and the face angle, we are going to get the value of the FA axial force as 928.84 newtons. Then we have to find out what is the mean pressure that is acting on the cone surfaces. We have the equation number 13.10c for the axial force given by FA is equal to pi dm pb sin alpha. From this equation, we know all other things except the pressure P. So substituting all these values, FA value 928.84 newtons, then mean diameter, then face width and face angle, we're going to get the value of the pressure P as 0.0844 megapascal. Coming to the next problem, a friction cone clutch has to transmit a torque of 200 Nm at 1440 rpm. The longer diameter of the cone is 350 mm. The cone pitch angle is 6.25 degree. The face width should be the face width. The face width is 65 mm. The coefficient of friction is 0.2. Determine the axial force required to transmit the torque and the average normal pressure on the contact surface when the maximum torque is transmitted. So in this problem, they have given the value of torque in Newton meters. So we have to convert it into Newton millimeters. RPM is 1440. Outside diameter is given as 350 mm. The pitch angle is alpha, that is 6.25 degrees. Face width is b, small letter b, that is 65 mm, and coefficient of friction is given as 0.2. So in order to find out the axial force for the cone clutch, if we find out the angle sin alpha, that will be given by d naught minus dm divided by 2 whole divided by b by 2. So 2 and 2 cancels. Therefore, we can write d naught minus dm as b sin alpha, or d naught can be written as dm plus b sin alpha. So substituting the value of the outside diameter, that is 350, and also the face width and face angle, we can find out what is the mean diameter from this particular equation. So it will be 342.92 mm. Now using the torque equation, we can find out the axial force, because torque is given in the problem and dm we have just found out. So substituting all the values, we get the value of the FA, the axial force, as 634.94 newtons. To find out the average normal pressure, we have the equation number 13.10c given by FA is equal to pi dm pb sin alpha. Substituting the values of the axial force, mean diameter, face width and face angle, we are going to get the value of pressure, or the average normal pressure, as 0.0833 newtons per millimeter square or megapascal.